Welcome back to my channel, Asian Cooks Arabic.
Hi babies, for today's recipe, it's requested by someone. He's craving for this one. I don't know why they wrote it red kidney beans, but it's not actually a red kidney beans. So our recipe for today is fasulia with white beans. So in Philippines, we use these beans to for the dessert, you know. We are using these beans for sweet dessert. But I miss na beans. But in Arabic, we use these white beans for fasulia. So let's start with our fasulia.
I'm going to share with you guys another special recipe, which is fasulia but with white beans. There is two type of fasulia, one with the green beans, but this one I'm going to share with you, which is the white beans. So we need 1 kg of white beans. I need some fats because I'm a fat lover. If you are not a fat lover, you can remove the fats. I need some good quality of meat, about 1/2 kg. You can use lamb if you want. 1/2 kg tomatoes and 1 large onion. So we're gonna slice it later on. We need some chicken cubes. As always, I always add chicken cubes in my dish. And I'm gonna be using tomato paste, the pure one, which is from Aleppo, Syria. And we have the spices. We have the salt, white pepper, baharat, cardamom, and cumin. So these are the spices that we need. But there is one more spices that we need that will be on the last of the dish when we finish. So let's start. The white beans, you have to soak it overnight if you're planning to cook it the next day. Remember that, guys. So guys, I start to preheat the pan, and I'm going to add the beef. I cut the beef into small cubes so it will not take too much time to cook the beef. So what you have to do is to just saute the beef, and you have to close it and cook it for 15 minutes in low fire. I explained that to my previous video before why it's always low fire. In that way, the beef will cook soft and tender and juicy. Don't cook the beef in high flame. So that's the other one. So we have to close it. So we'll cook this one for 15 minutes. So in a separate pan, I'm going to start boiling the fasulia in low fire. So it's about 30 minutes or 25 to 30 minutes. And this way, we want to cook the fasulia in a halfway cook. Like, it's not totally cooked, it's halfway cooked. So you just put low fire. You have to be always be patient when you are cooking, especially Arab dishes, because they have a lot of like spices to use. Not like Asian, we only use salt, pepper, and magic syrup. But Arabic, it's always coming with a lot of spices, and just be patient while cooking. So while I'm cooking the beans, I'm cooking the meat. And I'm going to slice the tomato and the onion. So you save the time. Guys, while I'm cutting the tomato, let me tell you something about me. I'm the person that even I stay 1 year or keep me in the house, I love to sit in the house really. I enjoy cooking. I love cooking, and especially when after I cook, the people who will try my food, they will tell me, wow, amazing. Like, they cannot believe I'm an Asian and I can cook Arabic. So as I said, I'm the person that I love to cook. Before, I used to bake cakes, and I'm taking so many orders, you know. that I reached the point that I cannot move my hand, so I had to stop making it. So I only make cakes in occasion, like special occasion, or someone close to me, like that. Before I used to make cake, but also I have work that's taking all my time. So now I just find time, and most of my friends are telling me, try to do vlog because you are good. Every time I'm posting what I cook like that, but I tell them I'm shy. Really, I'm shy. But no one believed that I'm a shy person. So now this is the hard part in cutting the onion, which is one of my enemies. So my enemy is the onion. My friend told me to put tissue beside me and I will not cry. Let's see if it will work. Because on my post last time, I really cried. Every time I cried, even without onion. Joke. I'm just kidding. So guys, whenever you cook and whenever you are doing something, make sure that you are in the good mood when you are cooking. Because that is another thing that will make your food nice. For me, I love to see the people when they are eating my food. They are like, wow, your food is amazing. How come you learned this and you are a Filipino? And like that. Guys, remove this mind like you judge the person by its nationality. Everyone can cook, regardless of nationality, as long as you have the passion to cook. So I'll give you the feedback, because so far I didn't feel that I'm going to cry, but I think it depends on the onion size. I noticed that the small onions are more stronger than the big one, so that's why I bought the big one, because I cried less. And I don't need to close my eyes this time. So now that the onion is finished, it's already been 15 minutes, so we can start adding it to the beef. So now it's 15 minutes past. 15 minutes. As you can see, that the beef released the water, and this water I'm going to throw it, guys, because I find it dirty. So I'm going to throw this water. So now that I removed the water, because normally when you are boiling beef, you have to remove the dirt on the top. But in this way, just throw the water that comes out from the beef. And then you have to start adding the sliced onion. Again, you have to cook it for another 15 minutes. Make it 10 minutes. It's after 10 minutes. Now we're ready to add our tomato. So it's a 1/2 kg tomato, guys. And again, you have to be patient and you have to cook this for another 15 to 20 minutes until the beef is soft. And guys, once you boil the white beans, there is white on the top that is coming, but I just remove it. And also you will see some beans that is floating. You have to remove it. You know why? Because this one will not be soft. I don't know how to explain it, but you have to remove the one that is floating, and that's it. Then cook it again.
So while we are cooking the beef and the beans, I started already frying the pots, just to release some of the oil from the fats, but not toasted. Just you need to cook it a little bit brown. And then after 15 minutes, we can start adding the rest of the ingredients. So I'm adding tomato paste. You can just bought the one that's in the packet, a small one. So for me, I added the big spoon. Not the tablespoon, the big one that you use for cooking. Then I started adding the spices. And then we have to cook this for another 10 minutes. And always check if your meat is soft. If it's soft, then you have to close the fire. Now that our beans is ready, halfway cooked, we'll add it on the tomato with the beef. So I strain it because I will not use the same water where I boiled the beans. How much water we need to add on the fasulia? It's just enough to cover the fasulia. Not too much because it's not soup. So just mix it, and then we're going to add also the fats that we cooked earlier. Mix it and just cook it for about 10 minutes. And also you have to taste if you need to add a little bit salt on the fasulia. Then cook it for 10 minutes. So the last one, I just added on the top 1 teaspoon of oregano. It will give a nice scent and flavor to the dish. Also, I'm going to add a half squeeze of lemon, half lemon. This fasulia is served with Arabic rice. Already I have a video on how to cook Arabic rice, and your fasulia is ready. Again, thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Asian Cooks Arabic. I hope you enjoy and try this recipe.